So are you using real AI agents, or is your technology provider just agent washing their tech? Let's talk about that. So welcome back to AI Insights Innovation. This channel talks about the emerging world of AI and how to make usage of it for your enterprise. We talk about what works and what does not, and really what's happening out there in a balanced and information forward way. If that interests you, please like, subscribe, and comment below. My name is Dave Linthicum, author, speaker, B-list geek, internationally known AI expert and cloud expert. And let's talk about this topic. So this kind of came about with people asking me about all this agent stuff that's popping up in the industry right now. And it's interesting because we're seeing, we saw, of course, back in 2008, 2009 through 2013, cloud washing, where everybody repositioned their products as a cloud, whether it was or not, that really had no bearing on things. And now everybody's moving into agentic AI because obviously the hype's behind that. And suddenly everybody has running their technology on AI agents. And really it's a bit of a confusing thing, because if everybody is promoting their stuff as AI agents, how they do that in just a month? What are the attributes that they're able to provide? And also, what are the advantages of AI agents, and what are they actually providing versus what are they actually claiming to provide? So I figured we'd take a look at what agentic systems are, what AI agents do, and kind of how to tell the difference between someone who has just AI washed their system or agentic washed their system and someone who's leveraging agents with the real architectural value of that technology. So the big thing with AI agents, and we're going to talk about this throughout this video, is autonomy. In other words, their ability to act independently. Autonomy in AI means operating independently without human intervention, making decisions based on situational awareness and adaptability. So the question remains whether today's AI exhibits true autonomy or merely simulates it through pre-programmed algorithms. And so what I think we're seeing right now is people are calling things agents, and they're really kind of bound still into some sort of a monolithic framework. So they're not operating truly as independent autonomous agents. So using the word agentic, which is fine, I guess there's no law against you calling your technology and positioning it into this technology space. But as far as what you're able to do, I think there's a bit of difference between what agentic AI architectures and deployment models really claim to do and what they should be doing versus what's provided out there. So what are the attributes of an autonomous agent? Well, first thing would be decision-making without oversight. An autonomous AI agent can initiate and execute decisions on its own without requiring human input, as we explained before. In contrast, non-autonomous AI depends on manual programmed rules and direct instructions. So we're using agents that we're selling as agents, but you find they're very tightly coupled to a common centralized infrastructure, and that's the infrastructure that's actually telling them what to do. And so they're controlled through a centralized infrastructure, but they're claiming to be agents. So there's no autonomy that's occurring out at the agent level. So in other words, they're taking direction from some sort of a centralized program, some sort of a centralized choice, and that's not what agentic AI is. So the next attributes of an autonomous AI agent for agentic AI would be decision-making without oversight. An autonomous AI agent can initiate and execute decisions on its own without requiring human input. In contrast, non-autonomous AI depends on manually programmed rules and direct instructions. So this is the assertion that we made earlier. In other words, that many of these agents aren't really functioning independently away from some sort of a monolithic, centralized control system. So they're basically functioning like traditional software. They may have generative AI associated with them, either a small language model that's part of it, or they're talking to an LLM remotely, but they're not autonomous. And I think, calling it an agent is a bit disingenuous. There's no, of course, laws and rules for what you can call agentic AI and not, but I would call out some of these deployments out there as probably not necessarily being AI agents, even though they're called AI agents. So the next attribute would be the ability to learn and adapt dynamically. An autonomous agent continuously learns from its environment and improves its performance over time. Non-autonomous systems remain static or require external updates to evolve. So in other words, you're able to set up an agent that's able to carry out behavioral changes that occur over time because they're able to update their native knowledge model. So they're running an AI system, which is dictating their behavior. And based on external stimulus, they're updating that behavior to adapt to changing needs, to adapt to where the business is going, to adapt to supply chain loads, to adapt to inventory control processes. You know, all these business reasons why these agents exist, and they're able to run themselves. And the power of an agentic AI agent is that through the autonomy, you can have these things carry out particular independent roles. And they, in essence, function like employees of a company. In other words, they're able to learn as they go. They get better at their jobs over time. And they're able to dynamically work around, you know, issues. In other words, they're not going to have to go back and ask permission through some sort of a centralized system to fix things. They're able to carry out roles and responsibilities unto themselves. And that's a very different animal than I think, you know, some of the monolithic systems we're seeing out there. They're being called agentic AI. So next would be awareness of context, you know, situational awareness in essence for autonomous agents. So autonomous AI agents can interpret and respond to complex dynamic scenarios by understanding contextual subtleties. You know, non-autonomous agents struggle to adapt to unanticipated or layered inputs. So if it's truly an autonomous agent, it's able to react and respond to certain needs and even work around things like emergencies. So we should be able to create an AI agent that's able to learn how to resolve problems on its own, and it's able to carry out problem resolution on its own. It doesn't have to check back with some sort of a centralized authority to make this happen. So the next attribute would be self-reliance in problem solving. Autonomous AI agents or autonomous systems generate novel solutions to unfamiliar problems without external help. Non-autonomous systems fail when encountering scenarios beyond their predefined constraints. So again, the great thing about autonomous agents is we're able to program them to do a particular task, provide the behaviors that they need to be successful, and they're able to expand their capabilities over time because they're learning as they go. They're truly AI. In other words, they're emulating a human very much like an employee of a company, as I mentioned earlier. That's a great analogy. And they're becoming better at their jobs, and they can only become better at their jobs if they're able to operate autonomously. That means, by the way, they're going to make mistakes. They're going to learn from those mistakes. They're going to update their knowledge base based on what they discovered from those mistakes. And again, not necessarily relying on a centralized authority. So what is truly going to be agentic out there, I think, is going to be very different than many of these systems that we're seeing rolling out right now. And you can kind of tell because, you know, if they kind of twisted, you know, directly into the agentic space in 3 to 6 months, that's a tough putt for these big technology companies, big cloud providers, to reinvent their technology to truly be an agentic AI system and use autonomous agents to make it happen. And the other thing is, and kind of the elephant in the room, you know, is there a reason why they needed to do that? In other words, is there a requirement that shifts their product set into an agentic based framework? Because in many instances, you can call it agentic AI and maybe it has autonomous capabilities, but, you know, does it make the product better? Does it serve the users better? In many cases, that's not the case. So some of the real world examples out there, autonomous AI includes self-directing tools like AutoGPT or autonomous drone capable of adapting to complex environments. Non-autonomous AI examples include traditional expert systems or virtual assistants like Alexa, which I can't say now because it's right there on my desk, limited by rigid programming. And again, dynamic versus static. So if you're an autonomous, you're able to carry on a dynamic capability and you're able to work with many other autonomous agents to carry out predefined goals. But you're independent unto yourself. Non-autonomous agents basically do expert system stuff, machine learning stuff, very traditional AI. And so those are the differences. So what are the challenges for achieving full autonomy? Well, ethical and legal constraints. AI developers must balance autonomy with societal rules and ensure safety, accountability, and compliance. If I'm going to build an autonomous AI system that is going to be on a jet plane and taking care of very much the safety restrictions, I have to think very carefully in terms of how much autonomy I'm giving that particular agent and what things they're able to carry out. Technological maturity becomes an issue as well. Most AI systems will still require human-defined parameters and lack the robustness needed for a true independence. And I think we're seeing that out there with some of these agent wash tools. Transparency issues. Autonomy is undermined by black box functionality. You know, it's unclear reasoning behind actions that necessitate human oversight. And so you have to keep that. We have to be able to figure out how to track how these things are making decisions. Data dependencies. AI systems rely heavily on pre-existing data and cannot emulate human-like intuition in data scarce scenarios. In other words, they can't get into the fact and provide the creativity and the innovation that we humans can do. We're working on that. That's the whole idea behind AI moving into a scenario where they're able to create an original idea, which they're not today. And so that's the limitation we're going to have to deal with. They're not humans. So we have certain capabilities as biological humans that allow us to invent things and really kind of have intuition in how we do it and use our experiences in much more productive ways. AI agents are very good at dealing with the details and the methodical details around operating a system, you know, shipping inventory, you know, manufacturing systems, things like that, where they have very particularly well-defined, very narrow roles, and they're able to work together as a team to bring things together. So are AI agents truly autonomous? Modern AI agents display limited autonomy. That's what we're seeing out there right now. So even though they're saying we're agentic AI, the autonomy there is not necessarily something that is going to be readily apparent. Often restricted to narrow domains where the actions are predefined or supervised. And to achieve true autonomy, AI must be capable of independent general decision-making without relying on human intervention. And many of them are not now. So here's the reality. I think that many of these tech vendors, whether they're putting out, you know, DevOps tools or operations tools or, you know, CRM systems and just renaming it as agents doing it, are kind of ingenuous because I think they're not necessarily living up to what agentic AI is. And also, in many cases, they can't explain why they needed to move to an agentic-based model. In other words, if they're not using autonomy, then there's going to be no need for it. And so they're spending time on re-engineering their system to follow a particular trend and not necessarily in re-engineering their system to become better at doing the job of the system and supporting the humans and supporting the systems that they're maintaining. Now, obviously, it's a general statement. Everybody's going to be very different in how they deploy their environment. I see that some systems out there are probably going to be truly agentic and have autonomy there, but very few. And so we're kind of dealing with this reality versus hype. And I think there's, in the whole agentic space, as I talked about before, there's a huge chasm between where the hype is in the agentic AI space and where the actual agentic AI technology is, and certainly the actual agentic AI technology that's being deployed within the enterprises. So that's all I have for you this week. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and also check out the other episodes here. Also, please check out my content. Also, my other places where I'm posting would be InfoWorld. I post there twice a week. I've had that cloud computing blog for the last 15 years. Also, my other YouTube channel, An Insider's Guide to Cloud Computing, which you can find here. Just do a search. And until next time, you guys stay very safe. Cheers.